back for game two of the finals. I've got to keep this hand. We don't have a one drop. We don't have an Ash Shallot. We don't have a Chandra's Phoenix. But we have Skullcrack. We have a... part of me wants to mulligan into trying to find a better hand. But my experience with the deck is that's just not a viable option. And I'd rather have a good number of mana, you know, some relevant spells, and all I need to draw is a single white source for the deck to be good. Like, literally, in terms of draws, I'm either drawing a white source, which I have 11 of. I can draw a Lightning Strike or a Magma Jet, which is either early interaction or will help me find a white source. Or I could draw creatures. So I really only have, you know, the Extra Shock, the Boros Charms. You know, my deck's about half hits, so, and I need to hit in the next two turns. So, I'm going to keep, it's not exciting, but, you know, fingers crossed. I think you do need to gamble a little bit in this matchup, because it's truly awful. I've faced it a few times. I've yet to actually win a match against it, so, it's just a really, really, really bad matchup. So this hand, if it gets a little bit lucky and I draw a white source, is actually very powerful. Doesn't have a turn 1 Glade Cover Scout. I like that part. And it does have a Skullcrack. So I just really need, you know, Ash Zealot into Sacred Foundry. Chandra's Phoenix as a start. Hopefully we get a Sacred Foundry or a Scryland. Scryland would be fine too. Just something to get us going. Fleece Mane. So if he has Fleece Mane Enchant, that's obviously really bad. And if we don't draw the... Oh, okay, well. Now, if he does suit it up, we can just Shock and Lightning Strike it, and that sucks, but at least it's manageable. It's a 2-for-2, and him gaining life isn't as big a deal as us just preventing him from having creatures in play. Do you have it? Or do you have a Fiend Slayer? Unflinching Courage. Yep, alright. So I'm really glad that he has access to like 8 life gain effects between main and sideboard. That seems very reasonable. So we're just going to kill that now. Again, like him suiting up creatures is fine, because he's going to end up with dead enchantments in hand, potentially. So if he doesn't have a follow-up creature here, we're in a really, really good spot. No, he's shocking himself, so he probably does. Fiendslayer Paladin, Witchstalker, so creature we can't ever beat. Got it. Understood. Okay. I just need to get bodies in play. Like, fortunately, I'm very unlikely to be able to block him down. If he has lifelink after this, then that's almost certainly game. If he doesn't, we're taking 4 and then dealing 6. So we can potentially win the race. I can always chump him if I need to. So, it's 3 turn clock. We kill him first, potentially. Depending what he has here. Another Witchstalker, so no, we don't. Great. Boros Charm that we can't cast. Yeah, this game is very quickly escalating out of control. Yeah, I really wish I could show you a better game 3. I'm going to have to trade for the Witchstalker, even though that means taking 3 and going to 4. Maybe I just can't. Maybe I just have to take 7 and 7? So I'm trying to think what outs I have here. Let's assume he has absolutely nothing. I take 7. He kills me next turn. I attack him for 6 next turn. So I Skullcrack him end of turn, putting him to 12. Attack for 6, putting him to 6. No, I just have nothing. The most... I could rip Sacred Foundry and then pump Fire Drinker once and Boros Charming, which puts him to exactly 1. So I actually can't win. Can't kill him next turn. Chain to the Rocks is dead. I need to chump the 4 power one with Ash Zealot. That gives me 2 turns, and I still need to end of turn Skullcrack, and then hopefully hit him with Fire Drinker Seder. Wow, this is... So that's the line. So I'm going to gain... Ashley Lord's now 2 mana gain for life. Or is he going to sit back? No, he's not going to sit back. That'd be crazy. He needs to put pressure on. Yeah. There's just... There's definitely draws that we can have that can win, but this was not one of them. So we're going to go to one next turn. If he has nothing... If he has another creature follow up... Oh, just the third Witchstalker. Well, I will skullcrack you in defiance, but this game is unfortunately very over. Next turn I have to chump with both of my creatures, and I actually think he just kills us. Kills us anyway, because, oh really? Just has it all, does he? Oh wow, the four Witchstalker draw. Yeah, I can see how that's beatable for me. In terms of damage, or chumping, I need to chump two of them, and it can't be with Fire Drinker Seder, which means Fire Drinker can't attack. So I would have to block with Phoenix, play via Shino to block, and then take six next turn, losing both of my creatures. No, actually, that just loses, because to play the Viashino, I need to untap the Sacred Foundry. So, yeah, unfortunately, that's the end of this video series. I got crushed 2-0 in the final by Green-White Hexproof, but we'll be back with more videos soon. So, this is James Fazzolari for Channel Firewall. Thanks for watching. Bye.